Today, I have a super cool but super easy vector ribbon banner tutorial in Adobe Illustrator, as well as a quick graphic design workflow tip at the very end. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. I hope you had a great weekend and that you're ready for some fresh graphic design content this week. I have a three-part mini-series dropping this week here at Satori Graphics, where I'm going to show you guys how to boost your graphic design career online for free. The three-part series will start with episode number one on Tuesday, so watch out for that. Now, let's jump right into this vector ribbon and banner design in Adobe Illustrator, as well as my workflow tip at the very end of the video. For this vector ribbon banner design, I'm going to use four colors, and if you want to use the exact same colors as me, I'm going to show you the color codes. Of course, the last color is white, so there's no color code needed for that. With a dark blue color, take the rectangle tool and cover your canvas in Adobe Illustrator, and then lock it in place. Once you have your background, take the type tool and type out one word. Here is the font that I'm using in case you guys want to use it for your design. If you then take the pipette tool, you can sample white quickly. And also a quick tip, press the caps lock button on your keyboard to get a pinpoint accurate icon design in Adobe Illustrator. Bring the text over onto your canvas and then use the Alt Option key to duplicate it two more times. With all of your text selected, you can then align the text equally and vertically. With the light red color, make a rectangle shape and then use the selection tool and the shift key to select all of the layers of text, and then bring them to the front. Again, using the Alt Option key, duplicate the two rectangles two more times to fit into your vector ribbon banner design. You can align everything centrally once you're happy with your layout. I have my Satori Graphics logo here, and I'm going to add it to the bottom as a fourth section on the vector ribbon design. Again, align everything after so you keep things nice and neat and perfect. This is where we're going to apply a technique to create the wavy kind of effect on the ribbon banner. So select one rectangle and one piece of text, and then go up to Object, Envelope Distort, and then Make with Warp. There are many options here, but we're going to be using the Flag Warp option. On the bottom two options, we want to keep the figures as zero, so play around with the top slider until you're happy. Do this for every single part of your design, but make sure the waviness isn't the same throughout, because we want some contrast on the vector ribbon design. Now, group everything together with Command or Control G, and then take the darker shade of red and the pen tool. We're going to add the behind sections of the vector ribbon banner design. So once you've drawn in the shape, bring the group section to the front. We can do this on every single section of the design to link the entire vector ribbon together. I decided part of the way through this tutorial that the darker red isn't actually dark enough. And here is the new color code. Also, I felt the sections of the ribbon were a bit too close together. So I've ungrouped everything and then I nudged them apart a bit more. You can also use a direct selection tool to adjust your design any stage in this tutorial. So here is the vector ribbon banner so far. We must add some finishing touches to the design, so group everything together and then take the pen tool and the darker shade of red. Draw in a shape like so, which will represent the ribbon curling behind. Like before, bring the group design to the front and then draw in the final part of the ribbon with the lighter shade of red. You can use a direct selection tool to adjust your shape, the shortcut being A on your keyboard. Then, arrange the layer order so it looks like my design here. We're going to add some shading real quick, so use a darker shade of color and then drawing a shape and arrange the layers like so. We want to lower the opacity so that it represents shade in a flat manner. I feel this is a very nice touch, and take your time to make sure everything is in order and you align the shadow perfectly at the top of the ribbon. Do the same for the lower section of your design, and then you would have completed today's vector ribbon banner tutorial in Adobe Illustrator. Next, I have a quick workflow tip for you all that I try to add at the very end of every single Satori Graphics video. So today's bonus tip will help you organize your design flow and your creative process in Adobe Illustrator. You should start to use the artboard tool so you can structure your designs very well. You can use the Alt Option key to duplicate your artboard and its design over and over. Then you can make adjustments as you travel along your creative process journey, for example when you're designing a logo. You can also change the name of the artboard like so, which will further allow you to organize your graphic design workflow. So I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial on a vector ribbon banner. And if you did, drop a like and a comment on this video. I have the mini series dropping on my channel this week for 3 days. All about how to boost your graphic design career online. So subscribe for weekly graphic design uploads. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.